Okay, welcome to my channel Maths with Mahanti sir. Children, today let us discuss few important questions on the chapter your real numbers. Okay, so here is an interesting question. See, suppose you are given three numbers A, B and C. Suppose you are given A equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 3, that is 24, and B equal to 2 into 3 into 5, that is 30. Okay, and C is given 3 to the power n into 5. We do not know what is the value of n. Okay, C is 3 to the power n into 5. And what else given? You are given the LCM of A, B and C. You see, this is the LCM. The LCM of the three numbers A, B and C is, suppose, 2 to the power 3 into 3 to the power 2 into 5. It will be 8 into 9 into 5. It will be 360. Suppose you are given the LCM of these three numbers 360, and the three numbers are A equal to this, B equal to this and C equal to this. How to find n? How to find n? You see, how can we find n in a very simple way? See, what is the process? The process is, you see, this 3 to the power n, A, B, you know, 3 to the power n is given, C equal to 3 to the power n into 5. We can write it in this form, 3 into 5 into n, 3 to the power n minus 1, 3 to the power n minus 1, you see. This 3 to the power n into 5 can be written as 3 into 5 into 3 to the power n minus 1. Why? Because 3 and 3 to the power n minus 1 when multiplied, 3 and 3 to the power n minus 1 when multiplied, it will give you 3 to the power n. Okay. Now you find the LCM. See, this 2 common, this 3 common, this 2 5 common. Okay. So what will be the LCM? So LCM is what you know, it is the product of common factors and the non-common factors. Product of all common factors and all non-common factors will give you the required LCM. So, it is 2 into 3. Out of these 2, take 1, 2. Out of these 3, 3 each, you take 1, 3. Out of these 2, 5, you take 1, 5. Then what is left? Non-common. Non-common is 2 into 2 and 3 to the power n minus 1. Okay. So, let us multiply this expression. 6, 30, 20, 60 into 220. It is 120 into 3 to the power n minus 1. So this is the LCM. But what is the LCM given? You see. But LCM of A, B and C, it is given how much? It is given 360. Therefore, you see, 120 into 3 to the power n minus 1 equal to 360. Now you solve it. 3 to the power n minus 1 equal to 360 divided by 120. It is 3. Now, this 3 means 3 to the power 1. You see, exponential equation. This became an exponential equation, and you know how to solve exponential equation. The base is same both the sides. As the base is same both the sides, their power will also be same, or exponent will also be same. That means n minus 1 will be equal to 1. And on solving, you will get n equal to 2. 1 plus 1, that is 2. See. So if n is 2, see. So if A, B and C are these expressions, and if the LCM of these three numbers A, B and C is 360, then the value of n will be 2. See, this is how to solve this type of question. Okay. Now another question. Suppose, let us discuss another question. Suppose you are given a rational number, see, 1, 4, 5, 8, 7 divided by 1, 2, 5, 0. Children, you know what is a rational number? Rational number is what? It is the ratio of two integers. It is the ratio of two integers P and Q, which are in the form say P and Q, where Q not equal to 0, means denominator is not 0. Then we call it a rational number. And you know every rational number is a terminating decimal. Means if its decimal expansion, it terminates after certain places. After certain number of places, decimal expansion of a rational number terminates. So if this is a decimal number, if this is a rational number, its decimal expansion will terminate after certain places. Now the point is, without long division, without dividing these two, how to know after how many places the decimal expansion of this rational number will terminate? Okay. The question is, it will terminate, the decimal expansion will terminate after how many decimal places? Just decimal places. After how many decimal places the decimal expansion of this rational number will terminate. How to know without long division? Without long division, without dividing the two, how can we know that the decimal expansion of this rational number will terminate after how many places? Okay, let us see. What is the simple trick? I think you know, children. You know, if the denominator can be expressed in the form 2 to the power n, if the denominator of a rational number, what is the rule? The rule is, if the denominator of a rational number can be expressed in the form 2 to the power n into 5 to the power n, where n and m are what? Positive integers. Then only the rational number has a terminating decimal expansion. So how to find after how many decimal places its decimal expansion will terminate? What is the simple trick you see? First you write 14587 divided by 1250. Now you find the prime factorization. You see, factorize this number. It will be 2 into 5 to the power 4. You see, 14587. Okay? This is the prime factorization of Q. This is P by Q. P by Q, rational number. Now Q is 1250. Find the prime factorization. 2 into 5 to the power 4. Now you see, in order to bring it in the form 2 to the power n into 5 to the power n, you see, now if we multiply here, look at, in this denominator, to the denominator, if we multiply 2 to the power 3, look at, here it is already 2. 2 means 2 to the power 1. If we multiply 2 to the power 3, then the product of 2 and 2 to the power 3, it will become 2 to the power 4, and 2 to the power 4 into 5 to the power 4, you see, 2 to the power 4 into 5 to the power 4, it will become 10 to the power 4, that means your 10,000, it will become 10,000, that means the denominator will become 10,000. If we multiply 2 to the power 3 or 8 to the denominator, then only the denominator of the rational number P by Q will become 10,000, so that it can easily be expressed as a decimal, and we can easily find after how many places it will terminate. Okay. So now, if we multiply 2 to the power 3 or 8 to the denominator, we have to multiply the same number to the numerator also, because we cannot only multiply to the denominator, because the value of the rational number will be changed. So the same number or the same term or the same expression must be multiplied to the numerator and denominator of a rational number so that its value will not change. Okay. So as I multiply 2 to the power 3 to the denominator, I have to multiply the same 2 to the power 3, that is 8, to the numerator also. Let us multiply 14587 into 8 or 2 to the power 3. Now find the product. 87 is 56, 5, 88 64, 69 6, 85 is 40 plus 6, 46 carry 4, 84 is 32 plus 4, 36 carry 3, 81 is 8 plus 1, 11, you see. So this is 10 to the power 4, okay. 2 into 2 to the power 3, it is 2 to the power 4, into 5 to the power 4, it is 10 to the power 4. So 10 to the power 4 means it is 10,000. 116696. Now see, now look at the denominator of this rational number. It contains how many zeros after 1? It contains 4 zeros. So when this will be changed into decimal, when we change it into decimal, the decimal number will also contain, or it should contain, 4 decimal places. That means, you see, we have to put the point here. It is 11.6696. That means this will be the required decimal number. If you express this rational number as a decimal, terminating decimal, this is the terminating decimal expansion, and it has terminated after how many places? Clearly after 4 places. Okay. So after 4 places, the decimal expansion, so the answer will be 4. You see. So the decimal expansion of this rational number will terminate after 4 places. Did I do long division? Did I apply long division? Did I divide the two in order to find after how many places it will terminate? The answer is clearly no. So I just applied the rule. Okay. I tried to express the denominator, that is Q, in the form of what? 2 to the power n into 5 to the power n. Okay. By expressing that way, we can easily find out whether a rational number will have a terminating decimal expansion or non-terminating decimal expansion. Children, I hope you understood what I discussed in this particular problem, how to find whether a rational number will have a terminating decimal or non-terminating what? Repeating decimal expansion without long division. Okay. Now let me discuss another question. Suppose you are given a question. This is a question on polynomial. This is a question on the chapter polynomial. Suppose you are given a polynomial. See, a polynomial is defined by the relation, say p of x equal to k square plus 4 into x square plus 13x plus 4. See, you are given a polynomial p of x in variable. You are given a polynomial in variable x defined by the relation p of x equal to, suppose, k square plus 4 into x square plus 13x plus 4k. 4k, you see. So this is clearly a quadratic polynomial because the degree of this polynomial is 2. Okay. Now, and you are given, you see, suppose you are given the two zeros. Zeros of, you see, this is given if p of x is this, and zeros of p of x are, suppose, reciprocal. You see, they are reciprocal of each other. Okay. If they are reciprocal of each other, see, then what is the value of k? See, try to understand the question. You are given a quadratic polynomial in x defined by the relation p of x equal to this expression, okay, where k is some constant. We do not know what is the value of k. Now the question is, if this polynomial, if the zeros of this polynomial are reciprocal of each other, you know a quadratic polynomial has two zeros. How many zeros does a quadratic polynomial have? Two zeros. They are usually denoted by the symbol alpha and beta, okay. Now the zeros alpha and beta, you see, zeros alpha and beta, they are reciprocal. Reciprocal. You know what is the meaning of reciprocal? Suppose they are given reciprocal of each other. What does it mean? It means alpha equal to 1 by beta. If alpha and beta are the two zeros of this quadratic polynomial and we are given their reciprocal, then reciprocal means alpha will be equal to 1 by beta. So if alpha is 1 by beta, then alpha into beta will be 1. That means product of the two zeros will be 1. But what is the formula for product of two zeros? It is C by A. You see, C means this is the C. This is the value of C. This is the value of A. And this is the value of B. You see, B is 30, C is 4K, and A is K square plus 4. A is K square plus 4, B is 30, and C is 4K. You know, every quadratic polynomial is in the form of what? A x square plus b x plus c, where a not equal to 0. Okay. So in this case, the value of a will be k square plus 4, b will be 13, and c will be 4k. Okay. So if the two zeros alpha and beta, they are reciprocal of each other, then alpha will be equal to 1 by beta. Reciprocal means alpha is 1 by beta. Alpha and beta reciprocal means alpha equal to 1 by beta. So if alpha is 1 by beta, then alpha into beta is 1. Then what is the formula for product of zeros? It is C by A. The formula is C by A. Alpha into beta is C by A. It is 1. C by A. So what is the value of C? It is 4K. What is the value of A? It is K square plus 4 equal to 1. Now you solve this equation. So K square plus 4, you see, K square plus 4 equal to 4K. Now you solve it. This is a quadratic equation. K square minus 4K plus 4 equal to what? 0. Now you solve it. It will be k minus 2 whole square equal to 0. Because this expression can be brought in the form a minus b whole square. You know, k square minus 4k plus 4, it will be equal to k minus 2 whole square. So if k minus 2 whole square is 0, then k minus 2 equal to 0. So k will be equal to 2. You see. So the value of k will be 2. See, that means if the two zeros are reciprocal of each other, if the two zeros of this quadratic polynomial defined by the relation k square plus 4 into x square plus 13x plus 4k, they are reciprocal of each other, then the value of k will be equal to 2. Children, I hope you understood how to solve this type of question. Okay. So if at all you understood, please hit the like button and subscribe my channel. We are going to discuss more questions on this chapter, that is polynomial, in the next class. Okay, thank you.